Hello and welcome back to Coding with T. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to design settings and profile screen. They both are going to be identical, so that's why I am going to cover this in one single tutorial. So first of all, let's quickly see what we are going to design. Okay, so we are inside our e-commerce admin panel. This is the dashboard of the admin for our e-commerce app, and currently you can see there are some changes in the dashboard. I have added some custom icons over here for each of the headings. Then over here we have also added the app icon and app name, and we can also modify these user profiles. So for that, first of all, let's see the profile and settings. So let's click on profile. This is the image of the user. This is the name of the user and or the name of the admin, and this is the email. So email is not editable, but rest of the things are editable. First name, last name, phone number. You can also add username as well if you want. So by clicking on this icon, we are going to display the media center, and in the media we have also changed this animation and remove the LOTI files, because LOTI files are lagging too much and not working properly when it comes to mobile browsers. So for that, we just remove with the GIF files. So let's select the users folder, and we have these three images. Currently this one is uploaded. If you want to upload any other image of the user, just click on add, and you can see it is loading and the new image of the user has been updated. Definitely this is related to the backend, but this is the design that we are going to achieve in today's tutorial. And same design is for the settings to save time. And in the settings, currently I have added few options for the app name, tax rate, shipping cost, and free shipping threshold. This means that we are going to make the shipping as free after this price. If user purchase products of amount 100 and above, then the shipping is going to be free. Whatever the cost is written over here will be zero. So let's get started with today's tutorial. Okay, so we are about to create the last video of our second last section of designing. We have completed all the designs. We have learned all the previous logics. As you can see on your left side, we have all these sections and each section covered in detail, and we learn each and every concept from scratch. We created reusable widgets. If you are new, you can watch the previous videos. You can get the link in the description of e-commerce app course and also the e-commerce admin panel course. And also you can download this complete code from the link in the description or directly from the codingwitht.com. Okay, so let's open our project. We are inside our project, which is the admin panel. And over here, the first thing is to add the routes. So for that, go to the lib routes, and in the routes.dart, we have tRoutes class. They all are static to directly access them. So in the tRoutes, we have to create two things. One is settings, one is profile. Make sure to add them as well in the sidebar menu items. And once done, let's go to app routes. In the app routes, you can see we have to add these two get pages, one for the settings, one for the profile. And we have the settings screen over here and a profile screen. So let's close it. Let's go to common widgets for the sidebar layout. So in the layout sidebars, open sidebar.dart. I have added a new section, which is other, or you can call it others or configuration, whatever you like. Then inside that, I have created these two things, profile and settings. And then lastly, we have a logout. So once everything is set up, let's close them. Let's go to features, and we are not going to work in the shop, but in the personalization feature, because these two things are related to personalization. I have added two folders for profile and settings. So let's talk about the first one, which is profile. Both are identical. You can follow the profile. We will also cover the settings as well if needed. You can watch that part also. So in the profile, first open the profile.dart, which is the T site template, and it has its own responsiveness for the desktop screen, tablet screen, and mobile screens. All the responsive screens are over here in this folder. So create these widgets, one for the desktop, one for the mobile, and one for the tablet. So if you're following the series, you already know that it is the same approach. First goes the scaffold, then single child scroll view to scroll the content, then padding from all the sides. And after that, the column starts with a breadcrumbs. First of all, this is the widget that we created already in the previous tutorials. So with the breadcrumbs, we have a default dashboard, a backslash, and inside the for loop, first we create the backslash, then we create list of items for the breadcrumbs, and down below we have heading of the page. After that, as a body in this desktop screen, we have two things. If you see the design, we have divided this design into two parts. The first part is the left part, or first of all, we have to create a row, and then the row is divided into two parts. The left part with the image and name, and the right part with the form. For that, we have to create a row, and for the left part, we have expanded image, then expanded profile. So the profile is going to take double space because flex is 2, double space as compared to the left part, which is image and its meta. As you can see, app settings is taking double space as compared to the left side. So this means the same thing is designed for the mobile, but we have to remove the expanded and everything will go into the column. So if I'm going to shrink this design, so currently this is the desktop screen, a smaller desktop screen, and let's try to reduce the design. Now we are inside the tablet. This is a tablet, and let's try to reach to the mobile. And now you can see we are inside the mobile screen, which is, and now we are inside the mobile. So we have a column, first section, and then the second section. So for the mobile, as you can see, we have a column, first section, and second section with a space. So in the tablet, the same thing, remove the expanded, remove the row, change it to the column, and rest of the things are same for the responsive designs. And then in the widgets, okay, the first one is the image meta, image and metadata, or image with name and email of the user. So first of all, we have to create the t-rounded container to add the white background with the border radius. Add some padding. You can see to make it a bit vertically large, we have added the vertical as large, which is 24.0, and horizontally medium, which is 16.0. So after that, we have a row inside that. What row is going to do? Row is going to make everything to take all the space available of that form or of that section into that expanded widget and make all its children to center. So we have to align it in the center. After that, we have a one single column. First one is image, space, text, and then text for the email. And then also we have space at the end. Okay, if we talk about the image, to create the image, I'm using the TImageUploader that we created earlier, but I am going to show you with the right 10, bottom 20, left is null, width is 200, height is 200. It is a circular true. To create a circular design, this is the icon, image type is asset, and this is the image. So if we open this TImageUploader, it has some static values in the constructor, and these are its variable. And down below we have a stack, because if you see the actual design, we have the image, and on top of that image we have an icon and its background. So to achieve this effect, we need a stack, and first we are going to place the image at the background, then we are going to add the icon button or circular icon. So this image is also in the circle. So to do that, we have two things in the stack. First one is going to check if circular is true, then it is going to design or draw the T circular image, else it is going to draw the T rounded image. And then for the position widget, we have these four values, and then the T circular icon is going to draw the circular icon. So if you want to see the circular icon, this is how it is going to look like. And if you want to see the circular image, this is its widget. It is going to check that if we have passed the network image, memory, file, or asset, and based on that, it is going to use the clipart rect and add radius around the image as required. So we have these different functions for each of them. So same is for the rounded image, just the radius is fixed. Okay, so let's close this. Once the image meta is completed, if we open the profile desktop in the expanded, the second thing is the profile form. So let's open it, which is this one, form.dart, and in the profile form, it is a stateless widget. It has again a T-rounded container with a padding column. First goes the heading and space, and then form with the column. So it is divided into a row. So we have two input text fields. The first one is the first name, then last name. Both are using expanded, and these are the properties for our text form field. And the same is for the last one, which is email and password. But in the settings, we're going to add three rows or three text form fields using expanded, something like this. Press Ctrl D. So in that we have text, shipping, and threshold values in a same single row. And after that we have a button. So this is how we are going to create these designs. So let's try to run this application to see if it is working or not. And the same thing is for the settings. Let me quickly show you this one as well. So we have image and meta. In the image, we only have one text which is going to display the app name, and we have the same image uploader, same things, same for the mobile and tablet. And if you want to see the widgets, image meta is exactly same. Settings form is this one. You see we have a row, and in that row we have three expanded values. Then we have a button at the bottom, and then at the top we have only one text field without a row. It is going to take all the space, called app name. You can change these settings as well. So let's wait for the application to run. Okay, our application is running, and you can see there are no icons inside this dashboard because I recently modified the main source code. So you can add those icons as well, and if required you can ask me any questions in the comments, or you can also reach me via codingwithT.com and head towards the contact page. Okay, inside this screen, let's click on this profile, and you can see we have the user image, name and email with the icon. It is currently not working. Then we have first name, last name, email and phone number. Email is also not added, but it is still disabled. To disable this email, you just have to pass a variable type enabled to false. That will disable this email. And in the settings, you can see we have a simple image or the dummy image. Then we have an app name. App name will go over here, tax rate, shipping cost and free shipping threshold will go here. So this is what we wanted to create. Definitely we're going to add backend functionality. We will update all these things, also update this icon when we're going to cover the backend. So backend will be started from the next video. Make sure to subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions you can ask me in the comments, and also you can get the complete source code from the link below in the description, or directly head towards codingwithT.com. Thank you for watching and take care.